Hello everyone, it's Carrie, and today I'm going to use something that's a little unconventional in the craft room today. I was surprised to see that it says use for arts and crafts on this freezer paper, but I got the idea from an Altenew class I recently took, so I wanted to give it a try. It's got some plastic coating on one side, it's pretty thin, and then it's paper on the other side. And so what I did was I cut it out using these layered snowflake dies from Altenew, and it created these most beautiful snowflakes. It cuts very easily because it's super thin. At the same time, it's pretty durable because it's got the plastic coating on one side. So it cut fine for me, and I'm just going to take it and arrange them on some Nina Solar White 80-pound paper. The idea to use this in your card making is to arrange it how you want and then iron it on so it creates a mask. I thought this was a brilliant idea because to cut these snowflakes, these intricate snowflakes out of masking paper might be a little tricky for one, and for two, to remove the release paper backing. But this you just cut out and then iron it on, and here you can see it's all ironed on, although I wasn't sure if I got all the edges ironed on. So we're going to test this out today. I have some distress oxides in a variety of colors. Blues, greens, and a yellow. That's scattered straw, which is one of my favorite oxide colors in yellow. And I'm just going to start with the darkest blue here. Now I'm going in lightly, but then I started pressing harder and look what happened. One of my snowflakes came apart. So now I am going in very gently around the edges of the rest of those snowflakes. I'm just kind of dabbing on the color. But I'm still getting a very good inking here because I'm using the domed blending tools. I had to press that one down too. Obviously, I did not iron that one on very well. So I will be trying this again, but all it takes is really a warm iron. And I just held it on for a few seconds. The edges, apparently I needed to go over a little bit more. So I held that one on a little bit. It managed to stay, and I'm just now blending those two blues together. I'm going to start adding the greens now. This one is, I think it's peeled paint. And as you can see on the edges of the snowflakes, I had to keep pressing those down. But for the most part, it worked pretty well for me. Now we'll go on with the twisted citron, and I'll just blend those two together. Now what is going to happen is I will remove the snowflakes after I go in with all the colors, and I'll blend back through them again to make sure I get a good blend. And then I'll remove those, and the ones that do not peel off easily, just add a little bit of heat with a heat tool. So it's pretty simple to use this in your paper crafting. I'm just going to splatter on some of this blue oxide color here to get some more interest. I really like this look on the background of a card. So this one is the Salty Ocean color. Now I'm going to go in with a little of the Shabby Shutters as well. I think this adding a little bit of the splatters actually accentuates the look of a snowflake background. So I really like this idea. And after I added the blue and the green, I added a little bit of the dark blue as well, and I thought it needed a little more pearly shine. So after those three, I added some pearl paint, and this is from Gonzai Tombi, their pearl watercolors. This time I'm just going to tap it on my finger onto the paper, and it creates a little bit larger of a splatter, which is the look I was going for. I'm going to use the Mary die cut from this set here to die cut out this word with some glitter paper. And now I'm going to slowly and carefully peel off those snowflakes. And look at how beautiful it left that, the white snowflake beneath all the paint and the splatters. So pretty. This one I'm going to heat up just a little bit to encourage it to come off a little easier. And that worked out really great. See, it just came right off. And there you have our background piece. Now, I liked the Mary cutout with the glitter paper, but what I didn't like was around the edges, there were a few issues with some of the snowflakes. So I thought a frame might disguise that. I tried this black frame, but it didn't cover it completely. And I realized that this was a little bit warped from all the splatters. So I ran that through my die cut machine with no die cuts, just with a piece of paper on top, and it flattened it out just a little bit more, which made it easier to put together. I decided that black frame wasn't exactly perfect, so I cut out a frame with some silver foil paper, and it comes around in a little bit more to hide those snowflake, the pieces that were missing, and I thought that was gonna work great. So to assemble this, I have a top folding card here. I'll go ahead and put it on with some liquid adhesive, and then I'll add the Merry Glitter die cut and that foil frame that I created. To flatten this out just a little more, I am going to add some acrylic blocks on top as that dries. That will encourage it to stay flat. And I was looking at these snowflakes that I peeled off that are from the freezer paper, and they're just so pretty because of all that ink on there. And I thought maybe, just maybe, these would stick on another card. So my brain is kind of going with that. As I finish putting this card together, I think I'm going to try a second card because I don't want to waste those snowflakes. I'll go ahead and set this one aside to dry, and I'm going to take the Nita Desert Storm background paper that I had earlier, and I'm going to arrange these snowflakes on that paper and iron them on and see if these will stick once again. I will take this one that broke and kind of put it off to the side so that you won't see that. And I think I'll use this frame that I didn't use on the first one. It's so fun when you can create two cards for the price of one. So I'm going to go iron that on and see if we have a winner. And yes, they did stick, except for this one over here, the one I had trouble with at the beginning. It didn't want to agree with me. So I'm adding a little bit of Nuvo liquid adhesive under some of those snowflake arms there. And then this frame will also help to stick it down just a little bit. And I'm going to show you how else I went ahead and fixed that. So as this goes down, I'm going to have to trim a little bit of that excess from the bottom of the paper sticking out there, but that's okay. I'm going to cut the Mary from some light green glitter cardstock. This is from the L'Enfant Spring Glitter Pack, but I really like that green for Christmas. So I'm going to use that on this card today here. And now to assist with my snowflakes to make sure they stay on, I have some Nuvo drops in a couple of different colors of green. This one is the Jewel Drops, so it's kind of more of a translucent. And then I have a couple other greens. I decided to go with the lighter green for this one, the bottle green. So I'm gonna alternate between the bottle green and the jewel key lime. And I'll just add some Nuvo drops here and there. I like to add them in groupings of three. And I'll just tap the back a little bit to help those to settle. I am gonna put some on the snowflakes here, but I'm going to use the key lime translucent one. So it won't really take your eye away from the snowflake, but secretly it's helping me to hold on that problematic snowflake in the corner, this one here. There's more than one way to make a card work, right? So I'm going to continue to add these, and until I finish the card, I'll add a few more of all of the colors. And there are our cards. Now, I decided this craft one needed a little bit of something extra. So you'll see in the final pictures, I have added some white glitter gel pen. Not glitter, just gel pen. And that, I think, helped add that paint splatter look like I loved on the first one. Here you can see the two cards where I added some of the glitter gel, no, just the white gel pen there, to make it look a little more snowy for this background. I really enjoyed using this freezer paper as a part of my new crafty stash, and I think I'll be using it in the future. It's really great as a mask. I hope you enjoyed this project today and that you were inspired to maybe try it for a card of your own. If you do, please tag me. I'd love to see what you're creating. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. I'll be back real soon with some more inspiration. See you then. Bye-bye.